Hey guys, welcome back to the garden. Today I got something really fun, spider webs. I've got really fun. Today I'm going to show you how I do the painting of my cement projects. So you're gonna have to start out with some exterior acrylic paint, and we're gonna start painting our cement project black, which this one's called wrought iron. So it's important to make sure that your cement stuff is wiped off pretty good. The next step is you're going to have to wet it. What that does, it gets down in the pores, and then you're going to paint it. Wet it really good, and then you're going to use your black paint to go over it. I know it's not pretty right now, but it will be. There. I'm going to turn it over and I'm going to wet this part. Now I'm going to paint inside here. I'm going to get it in all the grooves. So we're going to have the dark in all the veins. And I'm finding that the 2-inch artist brush is a really good brush, and it's from Hobby Lobby. It's not that expensive, but I use one for my black paint and one for my good paint that we're going to put over it. I'm going to use a green. Okay, so I'm going to take my small piece of cardboard, put a little bit of paint on it. Now we're just going to dry brush. Get your paint on your brush, wipe it off real good. And then I'm just acting like I'm just dusting. Just dust it with your colors. See how beautiful? Next, I'm gonna use turquoise. Oh wow, look. Oh, it's so pretty. And then I'm gonna put my yellow. Oh yeah, it brightens that center up. I like it a whole lot. That is how you're gonna paint your concrete with a dry brush technique. Show you this, when I get finished and I let it all dry, I always want to seal it. If you're going to use this for a bird bath or, you know, whatever you want to do, you seal it. Here is the clear satin enamel. You don't want to do a heavy coat. Just do quite a few light coats. One of the things that I like to do on the bottom of these is either put some felt on it or get some of those little rubber feet. And that way it'll sit on a counter and won't scratch it up. All right. I got them all finished. These two right here are sycamore leaves. This one turned out really good. Now this one is a squash leaf. Look how beautiful it turned out. See the dark in the veins? That's what you're looking for. Now you can do these any color that you want to. Okay, here's one that I finished today. And here's a couple more. I'm gonna do another video on some of the other things that I've painted. That I didn't make them, but I did paint them. Okay, y'all, thank you so much for watching, and we will see you here next time back at the garden.